Okay, so now I'm going to show you how we do speed in Finice competition. Everything starts when the competitors come to the starting zone, and then we are just putting these competition numbers and resetting the systems. So now everything is reset and start, and we can put the competitors to the starting pads, and we have this false start. Detection system, like if I do this, yeah, that was a false start because the competitors weren't sent it yet, and also that event is sent to the web that it was a false start, so the competitors will know it, and everyone will know that there was a mistake. So now let's start the climbing, and the block start, and the same time is also running on the web pages, and then let's say that when the competitors come to the top, we have these kind of things that you hit with ice axe, and that ends the time, or if it doesn't work, it just can do what I do, so just press this, and now the time is stopped, and we also get the result for the competition number and the time to the web. We also have a custom delay feature for the stream. If the stream is like let's say 7 seconds behind the real climbing, we can do that. And let's say that the right climber is coming to the goal right now. Okay, so that was the time, and after 7 seconds the same time will be also in the web. So 55, yeah, it's the same as should be. I also have a rough simulator how this thing works, so I can put a link below, and you can test it yourself how the web page is working, and how to get information during the competition. And now I will go through the technical details quickly how all of this is working.
Okay, so the alge-timing device is connected to the PC via USB, and the PC software is pushing these timing events to a web server. And in the web, we have these web apps or web pages that are registered via WebSockets to the web server. So the web server has like registered clients, and the server will push the data to the web pages, so everyone will get the data. There's no need to refresh because they are all pushed to the pages. And we could have like multiple clients or whatever. Like it's a WebSocket, so anyone can just subscribe to these timing events if you are interested about the time in the event. Thank you for watching.